chaired by Robert Kaselo, the Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure faced off with officials from Kampala Capital City Authority, led by the Minister of State for Kampala Affairs, Kabuye Chofa Togabie. They were quizzed on how Kololo SS land was parcelled out to several private investors, including the playground, which was allocated to Kampala Parents School.
For Kampala Parents to be the current proprietor. But does the MOU give, does it give Kampala Parents the right to be an appropriator? No. Actually, what it does is to say, let's work together in this place.
Really, is what do we do in these circumstances to save this situation? I can see you, these were civil servants, humble civil servants, very innocent, but let's put our heads together. What can we do to get out, to wriggle out over this sucker? Definitely, it's a matter of time. The thing will be, you will find a building in that playground.
There's a contentious issue around this Sudiru area, but there are also other developers who developed the land will change of use, because somebody, you're aware this was a playground, a sports ground. Somebody is electing a hotel. Was it in line with the development required by KCC in that particular location?
Whereas government entered into a memorandum of understanding with Kampala Parents School to develop the playground into a modern sports facility to be used together with Kololo SS, the secondary school has been denied access.
Not only for sports facility as perceived, but it's also a learning area, it's a classroom for us, especially from the lower curriculum. Now, we can't teach our children the PE subject because of the restrictions placed by Kampala Parents School. I think that's where the areas of contention also starts from. They are saying now our children are missing on the aspects of physical education.
That land was leased by Uganda Land Commission. And that was in September 2013, under Minute ULC 13/2013A, /267.
Minute what?
Under Minute ULC 13/2013, /A, then also /267. That initial lease was for 5 years. Extendable to 99 years, and the user for that particular land was restricted to sports facility. Now, subsequently, when of course the school objected, there was an MOU drafted by the Solicitor General's office between the school and the Kampala Parents. That MOU in essence made it a facility that was usable by the two entities, Kololo SS and Kampala Parents School. The school itself, for the people that were head teachers in the school at the time, are signatories to that MOU. Their contention at this present moment is that Kampala Parents School has more or less breached that MOU, and because of the way it was drafted, the clauses favor Kampala Parents.
KCCA was put to task to explain why they cleared Kampala Parents School to fence off the Kololo SS playground amidst the ongoing disputes. Committee members raised concerns that the perimeter wall has been used to block Kololo SS from using the facility.
Understanding of the law is that once the Solicitor General, for instance, allowed that MOU to be executed, which for all intents and purposes the school is saying is against the interests of the school, the procedure is you petition the Attorney General himself it is the Attorney General to reverse the position of the Solicitor General, and that's what the Minister of Education has done by writing to the Office of the Attorney General.
The Committee of Physical Infrastructure contends that allocation of Kololo SS land was illegally done by Uganda Land Commission because it was just a custodian of the land but not the owner. They also pointed out irregularities that happened in the process of parceling out this land, saying the minister who signed the no objection had no powers to do so.
We are aware that this is a sports ground which was for Kololo SS. Now government has brought a new curriculum which requires physical education. The school has no as a subject and it's examinable. The school has no facility, has no ground, has no anywhere to carry out such a subject.
Ronald Balimwezo, the Nakawa East legislator who petitioned Parliament to investigate the Kololo SS land grabbing, wants all land titles that were issued by the Uganda Land Commission cancelled.
My prayer is that we cancel the title. And I know we can get developers for the school for us to have a state-of-the-art sports center there.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.